Alrighty, guys, here we go. We're gonna push now into part two of our second session here. Yeah, guys, first hour went pretty well, I think. Pretty much kind of what I was going
I
for.
blew up a
Blowing
cart.
up the cart kind of threw me off. Definitely threw me off. Who's up first? If I'm not mistaken, it is Cassandra, not Cassandra, Sarah.
Sarah.
I was about to say.
So Sarah, yeah, you're first to go. What are you going to do? You can see everyone in front of you.
Well, give me a second,
Still,
guys.
nobody sees the person over on the right. Yep, nobody sees that.
Okay,
I think
I think
I'm
I'm
gonna
gonna
like
stay
stay
there
there
and
and
see
see
what
what
they
they
do
do
since
since
no
no
one's
one's
really
really
like on the other side of the log, no one's really made any aggressive actions yet.
Right. Well, yeah, I mean it's your turn to go first. That's why they
Well, I
haven't
know, like
that's
I don't know the full
I
like I don't know 100% why he had her light the cart on fire, so I'm just kind of like, what the fuck just happened?
All right, fair enough. I like it. It's all right with me. All right, so she skips her turn, and yeah, we move on to this. Now they get to go. NPCs get to go. Father White and Bree and Cassandra make a perception check.
Just as I fucking close the door.
Much
Hold
better.
on.
Much better.
I mean, I'll tell you right now. Yeah, you see him.
Yeah.
Oh!
Damn.
Sandra sees him.
Fucking
Bree,
motherfucker.
you don't see the elf over to the right, but Father White and Cassandra, you see this guy coming this way. Oh. Okay.
Fucking nudger. Do we see him?
Yeah, you see all these people moving. Actually, real quick. I'm gonna make a quick box, and we're gonna assume that the tree, you can like jump through this square right here can be jumped through, because
Okay.
it's been cut through mostly.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll say 4, 5, right at the edge of the tree. One, two, one, two, three, four, and then the orc. What's his speed?
He's burnt.
Yeah, I mean, you see him like he kind of
He's
shakes.
crispy.
Yeah, like you see some like burn marks on his face when he gets up, and you see him just like get really, really pissed off, and he just screams really loud. Wah! Yeah, like that's what you hear. You hear him scream.
So happy right now that little reference was made. Just extremely
Yeah,
happy
that
of
was
that reference.
amazing.
Okay. Yeah.
Not by me, by anybody else.
So yeah, here we go. It's next person. Actually, they moved and they can attack. Archer
What's in the
one.
fucking box?
Archer one's gonna try to attack you, Father White. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Slash roll d20, plus and she said Archer one. Okay. Plus three. What's your AC?
17.
All right, so he takes a shot and misses, and Bree's too short, and it goes right over him as well.
It worked.
Okay.
Yay!
And
It's
Archer number
raining.
two is also going to take a shot at you since you're the closest one. So let's roll D20 plus, and I said two.
One is Archer one, which one's Archer two?
Do you not see numbers on them?
No.
No.
Oh,
I see
okay.
one and
That's
then two
one.
go left to right, I'm assuming.
Two, yeah, it's top right. On me, for me, there's numbers. So I apologize. On stream, you can see it, but yeah. So my bad. I'll figure
Yeah.
out later why
This is
that's
ridiculous.
not happening. So two. This is it right here.
He's not tall enough standing on all his gold.
All right, you said, what was your AC?
17.
All right, so yeah, he hits you, and he's gonna do D6 plus.
He's gonna do these
He's gonna do
nuts.
6 damage to you.
Damn.
So he's gonna take a shot, and it's gonna come over, and it's gonna sink right, like near, like your ribs, right below your ribs area. No, fatal shot, but you're gonna feel it. It's gonna tickle a little bit.
It's is gonna tickle a lot.
Gonna tickle.
And then, yeah, that's their turn. Bree, you're now up.
I have a couple questions.
Yeah.
Actually, my first one's not really a question. I just wanted to point out, just a few minutes ago, you were like, hey, this guy right here, you see this guy? You don't see him. Just wanted to point that out. Like, show everyone this guy, but no, you don't see him. I just thought that was funny.
Well, I mean, yeah, everyone sees him but you.
But you, because you're too short.
That's true. That's true.
Well, yeah, you're, like, focused on all the explosions and stuff that just happened. Like, oh, yeah. God.
Look at boom, boom, make fire.
So then my question is, what level are these people?
You have no idea. I mean, you could do, okay, like, an insight check to get a closer look at what they're wearing, maybe get a better knowledge or understanding of their armor. It's only a minor.
Okay. No, that's cool. I don't give a shit. No, my second question is, right here, can the archer shoot at me? Because of the tree.
No, you'll be short. Yeah, no. I'm assuming if you go there, you're kind of ducking down. So.
Okay. What about right even here? So. Can they shoot at me there?
Nope. Not unless he moves over. If he moves over one square, he can. But where he's at right now, he can't.
Yeah. Our diagonal moves, is this 5 feet right here?
Yep. Okay. You could go diagonal. So you can go 1, 2, 3. It's only 3 moves to get to where the half-orc is. And then you can attack or, yeah, whatever.
I'm going to slap the shit out of him.
You're going to just slap him.
Well, No. You give me a second. I'll start. Dude, I'm going to do this.
Fucking wall again.
I hope to God he rolls a 1.
God damn you.
So
I'm hesitant. All
right. Bree winds up and slams his hammer into the enemy. you rolled actually a 1. I'm not even kidding. There's a red square around it, which is
Jesus
a natural
Christ,
1.
Breezy. How do you do this?
All right. Just roll a regular d20 for me.
How long does it take to make new characters?
And just
he's like, you're not stone.
All right, so it's not too bad. Yeah, you're gonna wind up, and you're gonna. Are you doing like a twirly attack kind of thing here?
No, this is just baseball bat. Like
a baseball bat. All right, so yeah, you're gonna like bring it back, and when you start to swing it, you're gonna hit the side of the log, and it's gonna kind of push you back a square.
Really?
Yeah. So it kind of worked out in your favor a little bit.
Not too bad of a failure.
I can live with that.
Not too bad. No. He rolled a 13, which in my mind, if you roll anything higher than a 10, I'm not going to do anything too devastating. It's kind of like a saving throw on your fail. I'm kind of nice.
Except for that 1 you got.
okay. So yeah, Bree, that's your action. Father White.
How much did I do? 11 damage?
No, you don't do any damage. You missed.
To the tree.
Oh, I missed. Okay.
Yeah, you do 11 damage gotcha. To a tree.
What is with you and
inanimate objects? He just wants to kill things made of wood. Can we fight enemies made of wood? Because we'll do really good.
You guys see that tree? Fuck that tree.
Man, fuck your tree.
I'm done.
Are you?
I'm gonna...
Maybe you should check their armor and use an insight check.
Mr. fucking Wisdom.
Mr. Insight over here.
Yeah, I'm gonna, I can see this, I guess I'll show you. I can see this guy here on the left.
Yep.
I'm assuming number 1. I'm gonna start heading towards him.
Okay. Yeah,
I mean, you said when the cart, can I take a perception check on the cart? Can I see the cart?
Yeah, you can see it, but yeah.
Can I take a perception check on the cart to see what fell out of the cart?
Yeah, you can look to see what's around the rubble. Yeah,
as like a free action or whatever you want to call it. Fuck.
Yeah, I mean, you're gonna see it anyways. It's laying all over the ground. You see shining off the sun shining down on it, all that stuff. You know, yeah. I mean, you see something that appears to be metal. We'll say that. We'll
see what I want to see.
Yeah.
It's their dead family, you ass.
Why is their family made of metal?
Inanimate objects.
They're one of those urn things, right?
Yeah. God damn. You're gruesome. All right, I'm going to move. Damn it. I'm hurting for a squirting. I'm going to move up here.
Okay.
And I'm going to take a whack at him. Go down. Hammer time.
I'm the only one who can make hammer jokes.
Okay, go ahead.
No, Thor is. You're just a basic bitch.
I don't think this is... I hope I set it up right. Alright, there
nice.
You go.
Nice. That's not... Mm.
No.
Yeah, you hit him.
And 12 bludgeoning damage.
12 damage. Jesus!
That's all max, right. So...
Yeah, well, how do you... what do you do when you swing at this guy?
Quarterstaff.
Like, yeah, like, how do you do it? Do you, like, come over the top? Do you, like, come across and swing like a baseball bat like he did?
Poke him in the butt.
Uppercut? What are we doing?
No, I'm always going to try to hit for the face.
Always. Okay, so you kind of came in from above. Like, because I'm assuming you just kind of ran up and you're like, boom. And you just kind of
try to swing around. Bludgeoning. Try to just run around the tree and just swing down.
Okay, yeah. So, yeah, you hit him in the head and, like, it breaks his jaw. Mm-hmm. And you see him just, like, shit, bleeding on the ground. Like, his sword is no longer drawn. And, yeah, he's literally just kind of laying on the ground, just holding his jaw, bleeding pretty hardcore out of his face.
You just slapped Kazal on the face.
You could tell he's still breathing, though, obviously.
Okay. I'm done.
Cassandra, what are you doing?
I'm going to cast a firebolt over on that asshole creeping.
Okay. I will give you a warning. There is a hardcore disadvantage to this.
Why?
You're shooting through trees.
You're shooting through a tree. You're in a tree. Yeah, you're in a tree.
For some reason.
And then there's two other trees. You know, if you're just shooting out of the tree at someone, sure, okay. But you're trying to go through two trees as well. I mean, if you want to, go ahead.
I'm just going to stay up in the tree.
You're not going to do anything. You're just going to stay in the tree.
You're super helpful.
Just going to sit in the tree.
Oh, okay.
Okay, bro. Thanks, bud.
All right, Sarah.
I told you.
You roll a d20 now. Actually, you should have rolled a d20 as well earlier. Did Sarah roll a d20 for perception earlier to see if you saw her?
No, it was just us three of us. Just
told okay. Everyone else yeah. To roll.
Go ahead and roll, actually. D20 plus 4, I think it was. Okay, no.
God damn, I see nothing.
Yeah, no, and no one called it out, so.
Oh, shit, that's what I could have done. Sorry.
Just fucking hang out in your tree. Hakuna Matata, everybody!
All right, like, yeah. Sarah, you're up. What are you doing?
Okay, so... Shut the fuck up. So I can't see this guy on the right, correct? Mm-mm. Okay, so... I don't really want to leave the cart behind.
I got the cart.
But you're in a tree, not doing anything. I don't want to hear
it. That far away from it!
I think I'm just gonna move like a square diagonal up and to the left, and that's
can't cast a fireball, but you can guard a cart.
Well, I could, but I don't want to need it later.
Yeah, are you gonna do anything, or yeah, just move and that's it.
I'm probably gonna take a shot at this.
If it'll,
there you go.
Okay. Number 6. Okay, go ahead.
Alright. See.
I can shoot him from here, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. You got a clear line of sight to him.
Alright, let's see if I can actually access my weapon.
It is D20.
I don't know. I just want to see if I can do it.
I see. Longbow's plus 6.
Sorry.
You're all right, man.
She just wants to roleplay. God.
Yeah.
God. He said,
D20 plus 6.
It was almost Wiener Dogs.
Yeah. All right, yeah, you hit him. It is a D10 for damage, if I'm not mistaken, for a longbow.
1D8.
It's 1D10 plus 4.
Is it really?
It really is.
Yeah, longbow should be D10, I believe.
Short bow, I think, D6. So, yeah, it's
We went over this last time. It's 1D8 piercing damage.
Okay, fine. 1d8 then. I like it.
Damn it, you motherfucker.
I'm okay with this. 1d8 then.
I mean, just.
Hey, you said it's 1d8. You said it's 1d8.
It says d40. You take it.
I'll talk it to
you. D8 plus 4. That's what you put in my character sheet. D10 plus what? Oh, now she's going to go D10. She's going to take it. Plus 4.
Well, because that's what you put in my character
sheet. No, you did your character sheet.
You did part of it. I don't want to hear it.
Roll, please.
I was typing it out.
All right, you shoot him, and he's just so caught up in running at you that he doesn't really see it coming, and you hit him in the upper torso, kind of like right below the shoulder bone here, and it just kind of brings it back, and he's bleeding pretty bad out of it, actually. So, like, it kind of went through. It went straight on through, and he's bleeding pretty bad.
Nice!
All right, so, yeah.
I hit a tree.
You did great, man. You did great.
Let's start with the guy over here on the left side. I'm going to start here. He's going to go and take a hack at you. What was his number? I think it's 5. Yeah, okay.
I thought he was laying on the ground bleeding.
Oh, he is laying on the ground bleeding. Yeah, okay. My bad.
He broke his fucking
jaw. He ain't going anywhere.
He turned his jaw into 2 jaws.
Yeah.
This is Kazal as well.
He's laying
right
there doing nothing.
That's Kazal, isn't it, right there? That's Kazal?
The half-orc right here is.
The one that you're fighting is the one that I, yeah.
You're facing the big guy.
Yeah.
Good boss, man.
All right, the...
what am I asking?
First elf right here is going to take a shot at Sarah, because she's the only one that he can really see. Trotter. Yeah.
Oof. Shit, man.
Okay, and then slash roll for his damage since he hit. It is a...
Little numbers.
8
That's not a little
damage.
Number.
And you did not heal before you came out, so any damage you would have suffered...
Guess what? Guess who's dead, guys?
Are you at 0 yet. Or... You're right at 0? Alright, so you're not bleeding out. You're just unconscious, laying on the ground.
Okay.
Guess who's... Why didn't you heal?
Breezy's still weak, too.
Oh, I lost
Jesus
1 health. Christ.
I
have 1 health.
Damage. I didn't think that we would have this big of a horde.
Of course.
You forget everyone's played D&D before, buddy.
Alright, second guy sees her fall down, and he's actually going to... He doesn't have a sight on anyone, so he's going to move around here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He doesn't quite have...
It's not line of sight.
Yeah, it's not quite line of sight.
Thank God you're saving those spells, Glitter.
Fucking tree has to move again. Damn it. I got to put these in the background. I forgot to put those in the background later. My bad, guys. So we got... It's right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And Father White, you've lost visual of said person. Cassandra, roll a d20 to see if you still see so and so. Yeah. Because they went behind some trees. You may have lost visual. It's probably for me.
Fuck, yeah, I did.
No, you've lost visual of this elf, or I guess ranger. But yeah, you don't see them anymore. And then this guy here, he's still pretty hurt, but he's still moving. One, he has half speed though, because he's hurt. We'll say that. This guy's going to run around as well. 2, 3, 4, 5. And he's going to take a hit. He's going to get it. He doesn't quite actually have flanking, because flanking, you have to be on both sides. So if they're in like diagonal from you, the other person has to be on the other diagonal side. It can't be like this. Like if the half orc was right there in front of you, Breezy, they have to be front and back, or left and right, or diagonal. So it's not all advantage right, in this case. No, nobody. You don't roll. This guy's rolling. Jesus Christ! It would be this guy. D20 plus. Nope. All right, so he's going to take a jab at you, but yeah, it just kind of hits your armor and kind of clinks off. And
fucking
then
gorilla.
Half-orc's going to move up, and if you're looking at him, you can tell that he's really kind of just enthralled in the idea of killing you. He's just kind of going crazy right now. When he starts walking towards you for this, like, 5 feet that you're away, you see him kind of... If you ever played League of Legends, he's kind of pulling, dragging his sword behind him, like he's Tryndamere.
Great. Oh, fucking great. If he casts some Dying Rage, I'm going to be pissed.
He's not level 6 yet.
God damn.
So, all right. And he's going to do just an all-out reckless attack. Okay? So he's going to get advantage. He gets advantage, which means he gets to roll the d20.
Okay.
And he takes the higher of the two dice in this scenario.
Okay.
Where's it at? Say it's +4. Oh, and then one more because 2. All right. Did either one of them hit? Like, does either one of those hit you? 18?
18.
Okay.
Jesus, Breezy. That's insane.
Yeah, so he comes over the top, and yeah, when he comes down, he like hits your shoulder pad on the plate armor, and it just kind of brushes it aside.
Got him.
That tickled.
God damn, here we go.
Okay, and yeah, that's his attack. So I think I've moved everyone attacked, laying on the ground dead. Moved up. Okay. Yeah, Bree, you're up.
My turn. Okay. 15.
Hold up.
Okay. Is he a fighter? Can I not move past him?
Okay. Do that. Whenever you, it's just like in, think of Card Hunter, you can't move away from someone. If you do, they both get a free attack at you.
Yeah, attack of opportunity.
Yeah, and they get advantage. So you're going to want to stay where you are.
What if I did this? Is that still the same? Because that
yep, still the same.
The cover. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yep, still
okay.
The same.
Okay. I don't have that flanking thing. Or I do have that flanking thing now, don't I?
You have advantage because he did a reckless attack on the orc.
Okay.
When he just kind of threw himself at you with his sword, he left himself vulnerable as well. Shift, I don't know if there's a shift in 5th edition. I've not checked. I should probably look at that.
I'm not sure either. I know there was in 4th.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to attack the orc using my advantage. All right.
Just roll the d20 thing like your regular attack. Take the higher of the two.
So roll it twice?
No. Remember the two dice show?
Oh, okay.
Neither one of them actually hit. So yeah, you're gonna take a swing at him, and he just kind of steps aside. You come across over the top, he just kind of steps aside from it.
Okay. Ah.
Now Father White, your turn.
I'm gonna move up to this guy, to the archer in the back.
One, 10, 15, 20. 2, 3, 4. Yep. You go ahead, and you can take an attack.
Yeah, I'm gonna crack him. Crack it to it.
Number one. Okay. You hit
5
and you do 5 damage. All right. So yeah, you come up, you kind of hit him in the jaw. You see it kind of, he starts kind of bleeding from the mouth. Nothing too terrible, but,
This is how he makes. He's also a squid person, apparently.
All right. Cassandra, you're next.
All right. That guy? How do I do that? That guy?
Okay.
I'm gonna try to set him on fire.
which one?
That guy.
I just saw... Okay, the pink one.
Glitter will always be pink.
Yeah, that's true. Oh,
of course.
I have to. Glitter.
Okay,
on.
Yeah, go ahead and make an attack roll at least. It's, It doesn't say. Make a range field attack. Yeah, do a spell, I guess... A d20 plus... I don't know what her spell cast is. I need to look. Keep that up. Cassandra Cuff. Pop out.
I'm assuming it's her charisma modifier, right?
It's charisma and something else. I think it's plus her proficiency as well.
Yeah, I got good charisma.
Let's just go to spells.
I'm going to set this guy on fire. Why not? I'm bored in this tree.
Firebolt.
I do though. I'm chaotic neutral, bruh.
You're bored, but I have an arrow pretty much making me a shish kebab. Breezy's about to be an orc sandwich. Sarah's dead, pretty much.
It's
hope we meet another elf here in the next
She's
town.
She's sleeping.
It's a
She's
d20
sleeping.
Plus 7.
I'm at a d20
guys. Plus 7?
Yeah, because she has a plus 5 on her modifier. Jesus.
Damn! Jeez. Holy shit!
All right, roll the damage on it. D10. Yeah, roll a D10.
Just a D10, yeah.
Slash roll D10.
Really better.
Why don't you use a real spell?
That's a good one.
Your cantrips don't do too much.
I want to wait to use all my real spells.
You have
until,
magic
like,
missile.
More than one person's almost dead.
Yes, I know, but I can only use it twice.
That's true. Yeah, she decided to keep it, but we've lowered the rest time to 4 hours. So.
And we haven't really rested since last, so she can't really use that.
It's been 6 hours on the road.
Yeah.
You guys have been about 6 hours on the road, so she has both spells. You did what? 1 damage, you said? Yes. Okay. Yeah, so like you kind of like hit him near the feet and kind of hits his foot and he kind of jumps out of the way before it can do any true damage. So
he jumps back?
Well, like it hits him, but just a little bit. So, yeah, you only did a little bit of damage to him.
He made his socks really warm.
Yeah, exactly.
I was worried about his feces. All
right, Sarah is still unconscious. She's not bleeding out. She just got...
I'm just trying to chill in, guys. Don't worry about me.
Take a nappy nap.
Why is Sarah over there sleeping?
So,
her picture on the board is pretty much what she's doing right now. Just sprawled out.
All right, this guy's actually hidden behind the tree. But if I put him on the tree, actually can layer map layer. Boom. Okay, cool. Now I can do that. All right. Oh, so nice. He's right there.
On top of the tree now?
No, he's underneath the tree.
Under the tree.
Go and roll a d20, see if you see him. Because you are looking somewhat in that direction, so I would assume. Nope, you still don't see him. He's still hitting the tree pretty well.
Jesus.
Okay, this guy right here is actually going to move here. Actually, because he's right there. I mean, you get a free attack on him.
If he moves,
yeah. Because I didn't let you move, so I would do the same until we find out the actual rule. Okay. But yeah, he's gonna do it anyways. So you get a advantage attack on him. So the higher the two on a basic attack.
Basic attack.
Just a regular swing. Just whatever you normally do.
Yep.
And the higher the two d20s. What's his number?
Bam!
Okay, so like as he's like trying to get right behind you, you kind of notice it and you swing around the opposite way. Damn. And more or less just clothesline him with your hammer.
Did his head pop off?
No, but his face is kind of like inside of his skull, so he's kind of dead.
He's dead!
He's as gruesome as possible.
This bitch dead.
Alright, so yeah, this guy's definitely dead.
What was the last thing going through his mind? His nose.
He was actually really excited to get to do something special. I'm moving these guys out of the way because I know I don't want to forget that they're dead. Okay, so that guy, half-orc, he's pretty... He just kind of goes into a frenzy after he heard what you said when you kind of talk shit after his sword kind of brushed off. So, yeah, he's pretty fucking pissed off. And he...
I should set him on fire.
Roll d20 plus 4. All right.
Oh, shit.
And then he only swung with one hand though. So roll d8 plus 3. He only does 6 damage. So yeah. He kind of swings across and again, he finds more or less kind of a weakness in your armor. And he basically pounds on it really hard, and you somehow get cut. Like, maybe he pushed armor in against you, and the armor had a flaw
and
cut you. and since he's frenzied, he actually gets to take an extra attack as well as a free action, as a free bonus action. And he misses the second attack.
I have 8 health.
Okay. And then this guy here, up here by you, Father White, is kind of, how much damage did you do to him?
8,
1.
I think. No, I didn't do that much.
No, you did 5, I think.
5.
Yep. You did 5 damage. So yeah, he's really flustered because you just kind of ran up on him. He's going to actually take a shot with his short bow, and he has disadvantage on it because he's trying to attack you when you're really close with a ranged weapon.
You're like, hey man, how's it going?
Hey.
Slash roll. I'm going to boop your nose. I'm going to boop your nose.
Boop it with a stick.
Boop with a stick.
So,
shit.
Nope. The crit doesn't matter. He has to take the lower of the two because he had disadvantage. So he has to take the lower of the two d20s. So yeah, he roll an 8. So yeah, he's so flustered, he just kind of takes a shot and shoots it straight into the ground.
Okay.
And then this guy over here, he kind of, yeah. Oh, there's a tree. Jesus.
Trees moving.
Fucking trees, man, I swear.
Magic, you asked to fight wood things. We're facing...
All right.
This guy's going to take a shot at you, Glitter. This guy that you fired a bolt at, he's going to take a shot at you, but since you're in a tree, he's going to have disadvantage as well. D20.
I don't have that much.
Yeah, so he takes a shot, and it gets the arrow gets kind of caught up in the tree branches and stuff like that. So, Yeah, he doesn't do any severe damage. This guy's gonna get closer.
I love that tree branch.
He's gonna walk up to you, Breezy, and he's gonna take a swing at you as well. What number is he? It's number 6. Roll. D20. Yeah, it takes a swing, and it just kind of, you got hit from the right side and kind of pushed you towards him. He took a swing at the left side, and left side, your right side, is the stronger side of the plate armor, and yeah, it just kind of bounced off again.
Okay.
So, yeah, I think that's all for them. Bree, you're up now.
You know, fuck that orc. I'm going to attack him.
You're going to go for the orc, okay? Go ahead.
Fuck that orc. Is he in a frenzy anymore?
He is still frenzied, yes.
Can I go into the frenzy?
Like, no.
I'm pissed now. This bitch hit me. I'm pissed.
He dented. Get
really angry.
He dented my armor.
Cost me to fix
on my mother's birthday.
That bam! Was...
Nope. Oh, it goes with the 12.
Damn it.
Yep. He didn't do a reckless attack last time. So, yeah, the 25 doesn't count. It's
just
a 12.
Think he's made of wood, Breezy, and you'll be fine.
Yeah, you swing your hammer, and again, he kind of just barely dodges back. So, like, if you're swinging your hammer from the side, act as if he had a shirt. He doesn't have a shirt, by the way. He's just kind of open out there. But yeah, he just barely dodges back. Like, you barely maybe scrape him, but you don't do any severe damage. Father White.
I'm going to take another crack at this guy right
yep.
in front of me.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I would definitely say I'd rearrange his face a little bit.
Yep. Yeah, he falls to the ground.
I want to do non-lethal.
Okay, so yeah, you knock him out then.
The same way that the other guy's just kind of, you know.
Other guy's just kind of
fucking broke
issues.
His jaw.
Okay.
You can live with
this guy technically
jaw.
Is still alive. He just has a broken jaw laying there like a little bitch.
And then
this
I
guy
move.
Is straight up unconscious, so I'm going to take him away.
All right. And then I want to move into flanking.
Yep. So, yeah, you guys have advantage, and the orc will have disadvantage against both of you.
Do I have free actions left still?
What are you trying to do?
I just want to tell him to stand down.
Okay. Go. I mean, you can. Go ahead.
Just stand down. You're on a fool's errand.
And when he looks back at you, you could tell that there's no way he's going to listen to you because he's caught up in a frenzy. The frenzy... frenzy.
Who put the angry guy as the leader?
The frenzy lasts a minute, and each round is like 6 seconds.
Like 6 seconds, yeah.
So
I set the cart on
that
fire.
That was round number one of him in a frenzy.
It's a world on fire.
So yeah, Father White, you're done. Cassandra, what would you like to do?
Can I see this guy yet?
Nope, he hasn't moved since then. You don't...
Fuck.
I mean, yeah. I mean, you could... Actually, I mean, you know that there's somebody over in that area. Go ahead and roll a d20. You have to get a 16 or higher. I mean, your perception. Roll your perception. Roll your perception.
Roll my perception. Okay.
And you have to get a 16 or higher to see him. Yep.
Could she not attack the tree itself?
She could.
With a fireball.
But she doesn't know where he's at.
Doesn't matter if you attack the tree with a fireball.
But that's
right?
kind of metagaming because I know he's under the tree.
Yeah. No, I mean, if you're trying to burn out a forest, sure, go ahead.
Yeah.
The last time we saw him was right here. Correct?
No,
well,
it was way over
the last time she saw him was here.
Yeah, it was way over there.
Oh, okay. Never mind then.
Yep, so roll a perception check, Glitter, and see... Yeah,
There you go.
You could barely see him standing here, and you could...
Can I burn the tree down now?
I mean,
burn
if you,
him down. Fuck
if
the tree.
If you want to, you can, but you could tell his bow's not ready.
As in she has advantage, or...
As in he's not trying to attack.
Thing is, I don't have a lot of armor, so it's like... I don't, that's why I'm staying in the fucking trees.
You don't have armor? I literally have no armor. I'm wearing cloth pants.
I have 30. Okay.
I'm out there like Macho Man Randy Savage
hey,
right now.
Glitter, it doesn't matter. Do what you want.
Yeah, yeah, do what your character would do, yeah.
But he does not even have an arrow notched. Okay. Nope.
I
want to
protect
her. Okay, you can't do anything else now, though. Because it would have taken you a couple... You climbed a tree, you would have to climb out of the tree, and in that time, it's acting as if a double movement. Your first movement is getting out of the tree, your second movement's moving, and then you can only have two movements, and then a minor. You can't do an attack or anything. So if you want to just get down from the tree and then do something, you can. But again, you could tell he sees you when you get down from the tree, but he still doesn't have an arrow notched.
Can I stay under the tree?
Yeah, you can stay under the tree.
And then can I do something if I stay under the tree?
If you want to, yeah. But again, he doesn't appear a threat to you. He's not like these other guys just with swords and arrows ready.
I want to try to hit this asshole again. He already sees me anyway.
Okay. Go ahead. D20 plus 7, I think it was. Mm-hmm. Are you using just your firebolt or what?
Yeah.
Okay.
Could we kill the big ogre guy, please?
It's an orc. It's a half orc, not an ogre.
Yeah, Breezy. Okay.
I mean, Breezy, if you want an ogre, I'll give you an ogre.
Oh, God.
I got an ogre for you, boy.
Ogres don't fit in that spot between the trees.
Yeah, Glitter, you hit him. Roll a d10 for damage.
Fuck, here we go.
Yeah!
Okay,
there
yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, the bolt goes over, and when it does, it explodes, and he kind of just sizzles. Eventually, he's going to sizzle into ash because he's burning alive right now.
Yes! I killed another man!
Yeah. You are evil motherfuckers, you know that?
Neutral chaotic, motherfucker.
I have an extreme hatred for Jaws. I hate Jaws.
Okay, so...
Why is he going to ask a lot of questions with him?
Alright, so... Sarah's down. And we are now to the half-orc. So, he's going to go ahead and still take another swing at Breezy. He does have disadvantage, though.
Got this, Breezy. I believe in you, man. Yeah, That's why I set that other guy on fire.
He's just so caught up in his anger, he's not thinking about where he's really swinging. He's just swinging recklessly. He just keeps missing. This person's going to take a shot at... Nope, he's dead. That guy's dead. You can't even...
I killed that motherfucker. Yeah.
Okay, that's a fucking tree again. Motherfucker. I forgot. I put the fucking tree on the token layer. I forgot. This guy cannot be looted. So I'm going to move him bottom left. Bottom left is nothing. You can't loot that one in the end.
That guy had so much money on him, and I just fucking disintegrated him.
Okay, this one's going to come over here, and is actually going to heal her. So, spend a hit. Hey,
the plot thickens.
Roll a hit die. Your hit die is. We didn't put that on there. I think it's.
My hit die is 10.
Roll a d10 then. All right, so you get four health points back. And you're very groggy when you come out of it.
Nice!
And I mean, you still have the arrow in you, you're not bleeding, but like.
Yeah.
You still have the arrow from when you got fucking KO'd.
Wait, so who saved me?
You don't know. You're still groggy. You can't really see their face.
Jesus okay. saved.
Okay.
It was Jesus.
Okay, and then that's their turn.
It's Breezus.
That's their turn.
Breezus, please.
Bree, you're up.
Slamming the orc.
D20, you have advantage. Hire the two D20s.
There we go.
You hit him and you do 13 damage.
Christ. Kill him.
It is halved though. Krakatoa. The damages because when he's frenzied, when he's raging and shit, he has resistance to bludgeoning. So it only does I'll round up. I'll be a nice guy.
I don't want to be around your fire.
It does 7 damage. So yeah, you take your hammer and you hit him kind of across the jaw, and he's just so caught up again in his anger that he doesn't even care. He's now bleeding. His mouth's bleeding. You know, he maybe lost a couple teeth and doesn't even care. Doesn't even seem to have fazed him.
Damn.
Father
in the
White.
Butt magic.
I'm going for it. I'm going for the buttocks.
The butt.
There are no jaws on the backside of a half orc, correct?
Just stand
no. right up. Aim no. right towards the butt crack.
Ready for the buttocks.
Obstacle.
Yep, both miss.
I missed the buttocks.
So yeah, you take a swing, and maybe he was lunging forward to hit Bree at the same time, and you just weren't expecting him to lunge forward at the time, and you missed.
Damn it, not the butt.
Cassandra, you're up.
I'm probably going to walk over here and be like, who's touching the elf?
Who's touching the butt?
All right, where exactly are you?
God, I don't want to be too close because I don't want to freak him out because I did just disintegrate a person.
Is your cloak on or is it off?
It's actually off right now.
It's off? Okay. So he sees... Yeah, I mean, he's got a hood on, kind of like what you do, so you can't really see his face or anything.
He's already pretty freaked out. I don't think being closer is gonna help.
And then I'm probably gonna, like, I'm gonna be looking over at them, making sure that if I need to, I can set somebody on fire.
Okay. Roll a d20 real quick.
Actually setting anyone on fire.
Roll a d20?
Yep.
Oof.
Yeah. He's gonna kind of sneak off a little bit. You don't see him start to leave. He's still within range to see if you look back at him, but you don't really start hearing him leave.
Okay.
Okay, Sarah, you can do something now. You're still really groggy, so like attacking is gonna be kind of a no. I probably want it anyways. But yeah, you can move half your speed. You're still, like I said, you're really groggy. You just woke up from being unconscious for 30 seconds.
I think I'm just
seconds.
Gonna back up a square and get closer to the cart.
Okay.
You get in the cart.
No, I'm not gonna get in the cart. I'm not fucking helpless.
Don't get in the car. She might set it on fire.
I'm like leaving the cart, trying to like get everything together.
God, don't get any blood on my cart.
I can burn your fucking cart.
Please no.
Okay.
Then you'd have to walk.
All right. Half Orc is taking a swing at Bree again, for disadvantage. With disadvantage. Yeah, swing and a miss.
Nice.
Yep. And
Bree, you're doing great. You do you. I'm gonna keep burning things.
He's just gonna kind of
up there, little man.
Both you guys roll a. You and Cassandra. Cassandra, no, you don't have to yet. Which way are you facing?
I'm facing towards the
not
tree.
You, Cassandra. Yeah.
Towards the cart.
Fuck.
Towards the cart. Okay, then no, we're good.
Facing towards the fuck. Back a little
bit. Leaning on the cart, trying to get everything.
Okay. Let me feel my feelings.
Gotcha. yeah. Okay. Then let's move on. The guy down here, he's still there, but he's hiding. Okay. Bree, your turn again. With advantage, higher the two.
Fuck this war.
Higher the two.
yeah. You hit him again. Does half damage again. For
damn,
we'll
still
six.
A nice hit though. Damn.
Yep. Still does six. Last one he did have fucking seven.
Damn.
So yeah, again, you hit him and you hit him in the ribs and maybe you hear one or two crack. And yeah, I mean he's just still kind of failing. Crazily. Father White.
I'm gonna hit him. Non lethal.
Stop fucking being
non-lethal! I'm a fucking monk, bro.
What's funny is that actually would have done more damage if that does more damage than if he uses his other weapon because bludgeoning does half damage. So yeah, like you, what are you trying to do? Like donkey punch this guy?
Walk up and snap his neck.
Have you ever seen A Thousand Years of Pain? Just
yes.
Right in the
fucking
right
ass.
In the bottle. All
right. So yeah, you do.
Talk about putting him on a stick.
So yeah, you
who wants to sure. be a popsicle?
but yeah, you do that, and popsicle. You could tell he's still flailing relentlessly.
I bet
he is. You could definitely tell.
I would be too.
He's bleeding from the face, and he's not moving nearly as fast as he was before. You could tell he's starting to run out of gas.
Turn him into a puppet. Turn him into a puppet.
Take gas, I can set him on fire.
So, Cassandra. Popsicle.
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 Who wants to be a popsicle?
Let's. I'm gonna put my cloak back on. It's chilly.
Magic.
It's not like we're in battle over here.
I am the anti fucking hurting people. One.
Okay, I have a question.
Yeah.
If I try to fire at this guy. Okay.
He's dead. Isn't he? Is he dead?
Is he dead?
Oh well,
no?
Shit. Then he should have been attacking as well. My bad.
If this I guy? Try to. No.
No.
That guy is passed
out. To the right of Breezy. I keep forgetting about that guy.
Yeah, he's still going.
He's kind of still just
watching. He's just like, okay.
If I try to do a firebolt to that guy, and I don't have a very high score of my like my hitting, is there a chance that I would hit Bree?
Pretty much.
Yeah.
No, yeah.
You do it, Rich. You're the man.
What's the what would the roll be?
I mean, it's still a regular roll, but you still have a chance of hitting them.
What's like how high do I need to get to make sure I don't hit them? Like so I don't hit Bree, obviously.
Why don't you roll a 5?
Yeah.
Typically, crazy shit happens when you roll a 1.
Yeah, and like, crazy shit happens when you roll a 20.
When you roll a 1, it's like you'll see Rich's eyes fucking light up like, oh my god, I get to kill people. Like, that is like the DM's dream is when you roll a 1.
That's normally how people die, is by a 1.
That. If you roll a 1, like, you're going to open up a portal and both the cart, you and her, are going to get sucked into it. And you're gonna end up in Chicago, like that's
so,
what happens. Like,
you're trying to fire a bolt again?
I just don't want to be useless because right now I don't want to waste. I mean, I think these guys are almost dead. Breezy's not gonna get hit.
And then which guy are you trying to hit? This guy here?
Yeah.
Okay, then I mean Breezy's not really in the way. Just don't roll terrible. Don't roll a 1.
Don't have bad luck.
Fuck it.
Don't fuck it up.
I'm gonna die right now, aren't I?
You're not flammable, are you, Breezy?
I don't know.
We're gonna find out.
I haven't even eaten mine.
Is it a D20?
I've been playing. What?
Yeah,
did you get a haircut?
Just roll your attack like you would, like your D20 plus 7. Oh. No, you're fine.
Okay, well. Like you will, right? Yep, just a little. Sorry about that, guys.
Sorry.
Getting interrupted. if you want to roll, you roll a 6. It's plus 7, it's
plus
a 13.
Modifier, yeah.
Let's see, 6. No. You hit the tree behind it, and the tree is going to start slowly burning, by the way.
Oh, boy.
Like, right here, that's fire. It'll spread.
You guys are mad at me for not fucking doing anything. That's
it,
all
the
I can
fire,
do.
The fire will start
magic.
To spread 1 square every round. Okay. Okay.
In all directions?
Every direction, yes. There, perfect.
Nice.
Fire!
So,
and I helped.
Sarah, you're up.
And I helped. Guys, get out of the fucking tree.
Roll a d20. Roll a d20. Actually, never mind. It's not their turn. Go ahead. Do what you're gonna do. Don't roll a d20.
I was just gonna say that I was just gonna try to look around and see
what happened. Okay. Yeah, sure. I mean, you see a guy sitting up on the left side of the tree over here with it, you know, just laying there. You see
it's getting a little crazy with the fire effects.
Yeah, you see Bree and Father White fighting the orc you saw earlier, and you see right next to Bree is like a short, stout guy, kind of in the fetal position, which gives reasons why he hasn't attacked for a couple rounds.
And I'm standing in front of you. You can look at my butt if you want.
And I mean, you see in the back the carriage has been blown up. You may not recall it, but yeah.
Yeah, I actually don't.
Also diagonals named. What?
Are you about their carriage or our carriage?
For what? Their carriage is
blown up. Okay, I was gonna say, I don't remember our carriage being messed up at all. I was right by it, but I mean...
You never know with glitter.
Could I roll perception to see if I see anybody else, like, hiding?
Yeah, you can, but you're looking up there, right?
Like I said, I was just looking all around, just trying to see, like, what was going on.
Okay, well, you're looking all around, it's gonna be harder to... see the hiding person, if that's what you're asking.
No, I'll just...
So, yeah, go ahead. D20, I think it was plus perception was... plus 4.
Nice.
16. You don't really see anyone hiding. You just kind of take a quick glance around, I'm assuming. And like I said, you're going to see a lot of the normal stuff that has happened in the past couple minutes. You're still kind of groggy, though. So seeing further beyond, you know, 30, 40 feet, it's kind of still kind of blurry. So,
gotcha.
Question for you, Rich. That's actually kind of also for Sarah. So can she brace herself on Glitter, Cassandra, giving her a better shot at the person? Can she use another character to steady herself?
If she wants to try,
yeah. Better.
Yeah.
Would that give her advantage?
No, because she was just unconscious.
Yeah, I was going to say, I'd probably be at a disadvantage either way.
Let's just say normal situation. Sure. Just first shot. Would she get advantage if she did that?
I would make glitter roll to see if she could stay still enough for it. And then if that happens, then yeah, sure.
Cool. All right.
Neat. Are you sure you want to touch me? Pretty gross.
Yeah, it's not going to happen for a while.
Kind of slippery.
Oh, you already put your cloak back on.
I did, but then you guys got, oh, you're just going to put the cloak back on. I'm like, fine, I'm fucking going to set fire to the goddamn tree, asshole.
Okay, so, yeah, Sarah, is that all you're doing? Just kind of looking around? Okay, good. Half-Orc is going to take a slow swing at you, still with disadvantage. Plus 4 is a 15. Nope. Yep, nothing. Still breezy. He's just still, now he's just kind of clack, you know, clanging off your armor. He's scratching it up, more or less.
Fucking armor.
Yeah.
Buddy.
You.
The worst part is, he has an 18 with fucking full armor. I have a 17 and I have, like, hobo rags on. So, think about that.
Your dexterity goes into it, though.
Yep. Three. Yeah. Go ahead.
Dexterity and,
Fuck this orc.
Okay. Yeah. Go ahead.
You rolling to fuck the orc, or are you?
Nice.
Die.
Yeah.
Nice.
What do you do? What do you do? You kill him.
Krakatoa.
What do you do? You kill him.
I am going to literally come slamming down right on his head and trying to squish it. And squish
the fuck out of him. Yeah. I mean, sure. That works.
Oh, look,
so yeah,
brain.
Yeah. I mean, you see some brain and stuff like that.
Oh, really?
It's all over magic, like all over him.
This makes a sickle.
And so yeah, that remains. That leaves Father White up.
That's my entire turn right there. I can't do anything else.
Hey, you can move if you want. This guy's still alive, but he's just in a fetal position.
I have a request. Can I intimidate this guy what I just did? Can I roll for an intimidation to get him to?
He's already pretty intimidated. Whatever you're gonna say, he's probably gonna be pretty scared of.
Oh, I'm just like, get him out of combat. We're done. Like, lower your shit right now.
You want some too, bitch?
Dude, yeah, he's just sitting like against the log, like
surrender pretty much.
Yeah, he's not attacked for a while. When he noticed that all these other people were dying, so
yeah, it's like you guys are
scary.
Yeah, no, yeah, his weapons aren't even beside him.
Okay, good. Then I'm going to take him hostage. Or, like, you know, I'm going to keep him where he is.
Okay.
Focus butt.
So, yeah, he's there. I think we're out of a combat situation. So, yeah.
This guy over here is.
So it's a half orc, right?
Right here that's dead. This guy is. This guy's not. That guy's like more. He's. Yeah,
the guy
it looks
that
like
Breezy killed a half orc?
Yep.
Correct.
Can we all recognize the joke that Geek just made that he isn't half bad? Oh my god. That's so funny. God damn it.
So
childish humor gets me every time.
Yep. Go ahead. It's free reign for you guys now.
Start yelling at people, Breezy.
Yes! That is right!
Why are you transporting weapons?
Where's Rachel?
Where's Rachel?
I wanna I wanna search what's left of the jailer. Or not the jailer.
What is the jailer?
I don't know. I looked over and I saw jailer in chat. I wanna search what's left of the half orc.
Okay.
That's Jolly.
Yeah. Jolly. What all are you searching for? Or like are you just going through his entire body or are you
pretty
checking...
much wanna search him for any kind of like, let's say he has orders or any kind of paper, like anything that's telling him where to go, who's from who to who, you know, stuff like that. Anything that can help me on my quest to find out what's going on.
Okay. Yeah. So you start searching through it and through it, the orc, what's left of the orc, and you find a note in his back pocket. He doesn't really have anything else on him. I mean, he's got his great sword that he's been swinging flailless, and then, I mean, the pants that he's wearing, mainly just kind of cloth, and, yeah, the note in his back pocket. And
all right, so you want to send the note to me over the break or something? I'll worry about it later.
Okay.
What I would probably do is pick up the note saying, look, I found what I need to find, and then I'm going to try to run to the other two guys that I kind of rearrange their faces and attend to them.
Okay. Breezy, you see him take the note, by the way. You're right there by him.
Yes.
I'm going to walk over to my cloak and put it back on.
Okay, your cloak's back on.
Are you, like, naked under your cloak?
Is what that you, like, Breezy, what awesome are you doing with this guy?
I have a dress.
I'm just holding him where he is. I'm going to wait until Mr. Diplomacy comes over so he can question him.
Oh, can I threaten him?
If you want to, you can. In diplomacy.
Can I threaten him?
Mr. If you want to, you can, yes. I don't know why you're going to try to threaten him. What are you going to threaten him to do?
Him.
He's already scared.
What the hell?
He stopped fighting for like four rounds.
I exploded a guy's head next to him. I think he's pretty scared.
He needs a stern talking to.
All right, where are you taking him to, Breezy?
I'm going to leave him right where he is up against... Oh, wait, no, that shit's on fire. Never mind.
Yeah, there is
You guys might need to move. I set things on fire.
I am going to while this is going on, I'm gonna grab the greatsword from this guy and just hold on to that bitch.
I think we should move the fucking cart before we can't get past the fucking tree because it's on fire.
When wood burns, it becomes ash or charcoal and then ash, so technically we'd be able to move after it burned all the way through, would we not?
Yeah.
Are we going to send Larry for it to burn?
Yeah, I'm pretty damaged right now. I think I need to heal up a little bit.
Take a little nappy nap.
I'm going to take a nappy nap.
I'm with you there, Breezy.
Yeah. You heal. Some of us are actually in combat this game.
A full night of rest gives you one hit point. Understand that.
Okay.
I would only need 4 hours.
I am going to take this guy, and I'm going to put him up against the cart here. Okay. Like, I'm gonna like force him up against the cart, like to, like, you know what I mean, like
sniff
hold
it.
Him there. Yep. I'm gonna take the greatsword and I'm gonna put it in the back. The horse the rest of my shit.
Okay, cool. Add it to your inventory.
Yeah. What's it made out of?
What?
Steel, silver, gold.
Just, yeah.
Steel greatsword.
Yeah, it appears to be just a normal.
Like a silver greatsword. Greatsword. Very good idea.
Is it silver or is it steel?
It's just steel. Magic, so you're gonna go search these other guys? No.
I'm not searching them. I'm tending to them, like, because they're still alive, correct?
Yeah, but these.
The guy that was, he was right here.
That guy, yeah.
Oh, damn it. No, they're the wrong It's
alright. It's alright.
I'm gonna tend to that guy, and I'm gonna tend to that guy.
Okay, yeah. The elven looking ranger dude, still unconscious.
Okay, I'm trained breathing. In medicine, so.
Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, if you want to bring him back to life,
Yeah, I just want to stabilize both. Or, yeah, make stabilize, sure okay. yeah.
You want to check and make sure, I don't dead, know, dead, Sarah's but... okay? I mean, she kind of passed out.
Yeah, he's she's fine. One hit point, and this guy here, he's still just sitting at one hit point, but, like, he's lost a lot of blood, and his jaw's broken.
I just want to patch him up, make sure they're okay, because I don't want them to, you know, do that thing that people do
okay.
when they're in elves and they get hit by arrows and stuff like that.
You don't want them to talk. I think you've sufficiently done that pretty well.
I've done well.
I want to walk around and see how much fucking epic destruction I did to that cart.
Okay, go ahead.
Whee!
Yeah, you get over to the cart and the cart's...
Can I do a perception check and just see if I can see anything in the ashes?
Sure.
I don't know, that'll do
it. Hold on, is the horse still kicking? Can we check that? Maybe the horse is on fire as well?
That's
a good question.
Horse took a little. I mean, it took a little bit of damage because I mean, obviously the horse is
Jesus.
The horse is attached to the carriage. It can't really dodge either way. You know what? Let's roll. Let's roll a d10.
Me?
Yeah, roll a d10 for damage to the horse.
Do you headbutt the horse?
So yeah,
damn.
So basically, it burned the tail off the horse.
Oh,
great.
No!
That's how they steer when they swim through the water.
What the fuck? You're not a boat, bro.
With a one, that's what she would know about horses.
Well, the one was for looking through the ashes of your fire on the log.
I was like, I walked over there and I went, oh, this is messy.
Fire. I definitely know this is fire.
This is gross. I wonder what happened here. Of course, this kind of looks like a thing. Guys, what is this?
Oh, I lost too much blood to deal with this.
So yeah, you got you got the two people sitting up there by the tree. One hit point. Half orc's brains are kind of scattered. Nothing else on him. Just the pants that he's wearing.
Take his pants.
Also, you see an amulet that he was wearing, by the way.
That the half orc was wearing.
That the half orc was wearing. Yes.
Me or Breezy?
Yeah, I took the
whenever
sword,
you searched him
would be in.
Okay. When I searched him.
Yeah, whenever you searched him first. It's a symbol of Kelimvor. It looks like a skeletal arm holding balance scales. It's one of the deities of death.
Kelimvor.
Kelimvor. Kelimvor.
Do I know this?
You're kind of you're a monk. You know your deities. You don't know too much about him, but you know he's a goddess of. Not a goddess, a god or deity of death.
He's a goddess.
Yes. Because logic.
2016, you can be whatever you want to be.
I can be whoever I want to be. I don't even know.
You can be a pterodactyl as a god. Then I'm probably going to go over with Glitter and check out the cart.
Yeah, okay.
Once I have these two guys stabilized.
There's issues down here. What is that?
Okay, so Bree, where are you right now?
Holding the dude up against the cart.
You're still just there. You're not getting. I mean, he ain't going anywhere.
He's not.
He ain't gonna go anywhere.
You can bind him.
He's not gonna.
I mean,
oh yeah, I'm gonna bind him to the wheel of the cart.
Okay, yeah, he's there.
I am. How burned is the tree now?
Tree. It's. I mean, it's spread now. I'm assuming you guys have kind of just really taken a minute. Most of it's on fire now, so probably in the next like 20-30 minutes it'll probably be burned down.
Okay. I am going to We have bandages? Do we have bandages?
I don't know, did you buy some?
No. I'm gonna take one of the square yards of silk, and I'm going to use it for bandages. I'm gonna cut it up and turn it into medical supplies for myself and for Sarah.
Okay, yeah.
So I'm down to 9.
You're going
to
cover up your wound that somehow got to you. And then same thing
so
for her.
Nice, Breezy.
As you're doing that, this elf's going to come out and help you with the bandaging her because you're going to have to pull the arrow out.
Yeah.
So...
Does that do
are you
additional damage to me, or does it just hurt?
Nope, it's just gonna hurt really fucking bad. Are you gonna do anything when you see him, Breezy?
I'm gonna go defensive, but I'm not gonna attack against him because I'm pretty hurt.
Yeah, he's just walking up. His bow's not drawn or anything. It's just around his back. Okay. And yeah, he's got like some herbs and shit.
Okay. I'm gonna just, you know, have my hammer ready in defensive stance, but I'm gonna can't attack.
Okay.
He's gonna come up and he's gonna start doing medical on like trying to heal Sarah.
He's gonna try to help you.
Okay. I'm gonna just be wary for a few seconds or for like, you know, a minute just watching him, and then I'm gonna put it away and kinda go to town and heal myself and her.
Okay. As this guy walks up to you, you notice that it's Layden. Layden, it's your brother from the town.
What a...
Oh my god, I almost killed him!
Jesus, thank god, you suck at shooting fire at people.
hold on. Have I recovered enough to notice
it? Yeah, you just now notice it. As he comes up to pull the arrow out, you notice it.
Next time on Dragon Ball Z.
Actually, it is break time.
Mm-hmm.
It is break time.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
Which,
yeah.
I missed part of it again, so fuck me, right?
Oh, God!
So, yeah.
Gonna hang that ass.
I'll have to do a little... What the fuck? Hang that ass. So, yeah, I'll have to do like a little recap of part of it, because I forgot to push the recording button again, because I'm a dumbass. Doing a lot of... Hey, there's a lot of stuff going on my side already to worry about, so when I forget
a
recording button...
We dropped the fucking command.
I don't read chat, though, very often. I'm looking at you guys getting this stuff set up, getting all the players and stuff, trying to do the roles, so fuck you!
Hope you already have with this big orc thing.
I hope you roll a one.
You did great, Breezy.
Thank you.
But yeah, guys, we'll be back here in just a few minutes. We went like 10 minutes over, so on that. We'll be back in just a couple minutes, grab a drink. I'm going to chow down some food, so it might be a little bit longer of a break, you know, 5-6 minutes, and then we'll be back going into hour number 3, foreplay. So, yeah. Rich fucking Rich press record. I just did. Fuck you, Glitter. yeah, we'll be right back, guys.